Hello everyone, this is my demo video, and in this demo video I'm taking topic trigonometry of class 10th, and here in this video I'm going to prove that why sine 60 degrees is equals to root 3 upon 2. So just to prove this, here I will take one equilateral triangle in the beginning. So my topic for the video is trigonometry, and in this video I'm going to prove why sine 60 degrees is equals to root 3 upon 2. So just to prove this, I'm just taking one equilateral triangle. So this is one equilateral triangle, and name of this equilateral triangle is ABC. And as we know that in an equilateral triangle, all three sides are of equal length. So here I'm considering each one as 2A. So length of this one is 2A, length of BC is also 2A, and length of AC is also 2A. Now after this, in this equilateral triangle, I am drawing one perpendicular, and this perpendicular starting from A and ending on BC. So this is a perpendicular AD. Now after this, here I am going to prove these two triangles congruent. And just to prove these two triangles congruent, I am going to use RHS congruent rule. So I am writing triangles those I am going to prove here congruent. So here I am going to prove triangle ABD and triangle ACD congruent. And just to prove these two triangles congruent, I am using as RHS congruent rule. So first of all, in both triangles we are getting one right angle. So here in the first triangle, angle ADB is equals to another triangle, angle ADC, and reason is each 90 degree, and this is by construction. After that, second thing here is what, that in both triangles, in this triangle this is the hypotenuse, and in this triangle this one is the hypotenuse, and in both triangles hypotenuse is equals to 2a. So in both triangles hypotenuse also we are getting of equal length. So that is the next I am writing here, that AB equals to AC, and here each of 2a length. So in both triangles hypotenuse is of equal length, that is 2a. And the third one is what, in both triangles one side remaining must be equal. So here in both triangles this AD is common. So here the third one is AD is equals to AD, and this is why, because it is common. So here in both triangles we have found one angle is 90 degree, hypotenuse is of equal length, and one side is common. So by RHS congruent rule, here we can say that these two triangles are congruent. So by RHS congruent rule, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. So now as ABD and ACD triangles are congruent, so now after this, here one more thing is that as these two triangles are congruent, so as this complete is of 2A, so now these two parts will be equal, BD and CD. So here this is because of the CPCD. So as these two triangles are congruent, so in this triangle BD is equals to, we can write in this triangle CD, by CPCD reason is, so as these two triangles are congruent, so we have these two sides are of same length. So here as this total is of 2A, so this part will be of A, and this part will also be of equals to A. So here that is the next thing I am going to write, that now BD is equals to as per this A. Now here after this, in this triangle, now I am going to use Pythagoras theorem, and by using Pythagoras theorem, as we know the length of the hypotenuse 2A and base is of A, I am going to find perpendicular height. So here I am using now Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle ABD, hypotenuse is AB, so AB square is equals to perpendicular is AD, so AD square, plus base is BD, so BD square. So AB value is 2A, so 2A square equals to AD value we have to find, so AD square only, plus BD value, here we have found A, so A square. So 2A square is 4A square, and this A square I am shifting in the left hand side, so minus A square equals to AD square. So in this way now we can write that 4A square minus A square is 3A square, so 3A square is equals to AD square. So here when we are removing this power 2, so we have to go do it, root 3A square equals to AD, so this will be root 3A equals to AD. So by using Pythagoras theorem, here AD length we have found, and length of AD is root 3 A. Now after this, I am going to find here sine 60 degree value. Now this angle B is equals to 60 degree because ABC is an equilateral triangle, and in equilateral triangle each angle measures 60 degree. So this angle is equals to 60 degree. Now as I have to find sine 60 degree, so sine 60 degree is what, perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So perpendicular here is AD and hypotenuse here is AB. So sine 60 degree is equals to perpendicular. Now perpendicular value we have found, it is what, root 3A. Hypotenuse value also we have found, and hypotenuse value is 2A. So here A and A we can cancel. So here sine 60 degree is equals to root 3 upon 2. So this only I wanted to prove. So it is proved here that sine 60 degree value is what, root 3 upon 2. So this one was a small demo video where I proved sine 60 degree equals to root 3 upon 2. So this is only in this demo video. Thanks for watching this.